Hey guys, welcome to the studio. It's Thursday afternoon. This is the day that I usually I do some experimenting. I play around. I want to show you a little something. It's a paper fold, and I've made these little books before. They're a lot of fun to do, and it's a great way to use up maybe some old art paper. And what I've done here is these are the roll-offs from some prints that I made last year. It was just leftover ink, and just came out of a sketchbook. And what I do is I cut a square piece of paper, and then I fold it in half this way. I fold it in half this way, and then you can see by the diagonals, I also fold each diagonal. So the end result is kind of a star-shaped fold, all intersecting at the middle. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to take and fold these outside corners. Look at what I'm doing. I'm taking the horizontal side, not a diagonal. I'm going to fold it in. This is a little tricky because you have to get this corner or this middle piece and this middle piece to fold in. So sometimes you have to have three arms to do that. But once you fold it, you should come out with a triangle like so. If you saw, you can see my painting to the inside. Okay. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take one corner and I'm going to fold it to the middle, like so. And I'm going to do it to the other corner. A lot of times when I do these folds, those first folds that I showed you, the diagonal and the horizontal ones, it really helps to fold those both directions. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is I folded these into the middle, just follow that seam. I'm going to unfold them, reach my finger in here, and I am going to reverse that point now. Okay, so now it's on the inside. I've simply moved it from the outside to the inside, and I'm going to do the same thing on the other side. I open it up a little bit, and I push in that fold. Okay, so you can see it's been pushed in. All right, now I'm gonna flip it over and do it exactly the same on the other side, like so, and like so. Okay, so you can see the difference. This side, it's been folded inward. This side hasn't been folded in yet, but you see the shape, kind of like a little crown. Now I'm gonna do the same thing here. Open it up a little bit. It really helps to kind of push your finger down into where the fold is or nearby. Push that in. It should go pretty easily. Okay, same thing here. I'm gonna go in down near where it intersects. All right, just flatten it down. And now when I open it up, I've created a little pouch of sorts. Can you see that? All right, here's another one that I made earlier. Again, just using up some scrap papers, some leftover from inking, but you can use any paper that's cut square, and then you can make a little cover for it. And you just glue it in. You take these, take these points, just make a cover that will fit over it, glue it. This one, I just used some cardstock. I actually made this fold out of an old map. Okay, and in this one, I cut a hole in the cover. And now what I can do is in this book, I can put things. I could put my intent. I'm gonna be putting some old photographs in here, kind of a little collection. In these that I'm going to be making, I'll do a little collection of things that I can put in here, and then I can make some sort of a little closure. And it's kind of like a little keepsake book or a little scrapbook. You could use your imagination. You could do designs in here. You could collage new things. This is called a Turkish fold. Look it up online. You can find some directions for it. It's a lot of fun. Like I said, I'm making some gifts now for Christmas for people. And yeah, so there it is. enjoy it. Thanks for joining me today. Bye-bye.